So, somehow I've not recorded the cost and standard 60 cycle yet, and I thought, what a better way to show the cost and standard 60 cycle than to do a famous bedding and towel wash. Now, stay tuned for some potentially really unbalanced spins, some maybe a potential sus lock, we don't know yet, but start out with my tea towel. I've got a pillowcase, then a standard size towel, another pillowcase, a bed sheet, a hand towel, another tea towel, and another hand towel, a bed sheet, a standard size towel. Gonna go at the back. Two more tea towels. The pillowcase, which is gonna go down the bottom here, alongside those two tea towels. And of course, a bath mat to make it more fun. And finally, a little face mask. So, I'm actually gonna try and get some stuff around the bath mat as well to sort of even it out a bit. So, should be able to get the washables in alongside those. Just throw them up the top there, at the back. There we go. I'll put that down there, and then this down there. Right, so I'm going to need some laundry powder today. I'm not going to use any tablets for this wash. I am, however, going to put in a colour catcher, so, because we've got some blue bedding in there. So, colour catcher in. That's going to just go. Actually, I'll just throw that down here, might as well. This is probably going to be the most interesting wash I've done for a long time. The most interesting wash on my channel. Probably. In there. I'm going to overdose it as well. So I'm going to put that much in total, which is 100 milliliters into the drawer. And 85 into the drum. Which is not really overdosing actually, given the load size, but oh well. Let's put that up the top of here. So, cost and standard 60, which it defaults to anyway. Let's go. I'm going to put in some Ball Mat So Soft softener. I'm going to put in... No, I'm not, that's a lie. Don't put softener with towels, because it impacts their absorbency. Bring my phone over here. Thank you. when I re-rinse the bedding, I'll make a 4K60 video on my iPad. think I overdosed it, would you? Thank you. What's the correct dose for it's light soil when it's soft water?
45 milliliters.
That's 3 times the amount of dispersion. it's not charging very fast.
I think the setup I've got for charging isn't working right. So, hold on, bear with me. But you wouldn't have noticed anything. Why is this charger so hot? I'm going to plug it into the other wall. I'm going to take temperature over first. Why is it 35 degrees on the plastic?
Like if it was 35, I'd better not understand, but it's not.
Now, although this video has been one of the, it would have been recorded a lot earlier than the videos that are coming out between now and June. A lot later, rather. So this is probably being recorded 2 days before you see it. It's been recorded on Sunday the 25th of April. And you'll probably see, I have plans to release it on Tuesday the 27th of April. Now, all videos before, and all videos with the beko coming in future, unless I'm specified, have been recorded before this video. And I mean, 3 or 4 weeks before this video, at least. This video ends, well, like 40 minutes before this video ends, I've got a video releasing of the LG doing a single wide test. I'm guessing it's at about 25.
I wasn't too far off, 26.3.
actually excited for the spins on this one. They might be fun. Now, with this cycle, I thought I'd done it. Because naturally, Costa Standard 60 is one of the first cycles I film on machines, because it's my favourite one on most machines. But somehow I've not done it yet. I don't know why. I think it's because I did Costa Standard 60 as the first one back in my videos, which were in really low resolution, which are non-existent now, because I deleted them like nearly a year ago. Now I started over when I got my new Android in September. That's when the videos obviously launched. I had hundreds of videos before that though. Obviously, you can check my channel's been going since 2018, I think. I have restarted the future. I didn't really make much videos until 2019. Couldn't really, to be fair. Let's look, I can show you. So on my about, we've actually... Oh, it won't focus, will it? Because I've got it in manual focus mode. 11th of August 2018. So... Okay, that's a focus there. Focus, please, fine. There we go. It's not focusing properly now. I've messed up the focus completely. Turn it that way and turn it back. So, sorry, bear with me. There we go. Thank you. Yeah, I don't know why that's happened. Now that I got it out of the way, but oh well. Well, I'm still trying to... There we go, that's what I wanted. Right, it's sort of there. I'm hoping that if the machine moves, then, which I think it will do, to be fair, then it will sort itself out.
I'm genuinely hoping I can fix this issue. I've got a lighting glitch. If you just skip to this point in the video, then you'll notice that it's a bit darker than it should be. But it's just a lighting glitch, and I don't know why, because usually it works fine, but I'm trying to get it back to the same light as it was before, but if I try and do that, I mean, see, now you can see flickering on the screen, and it's also not the right brightness it should be. Hopefully that will do the job. If I try and focus on that blue towel, that's better, a bit better. I mean, it's a little better than before. Still not as light as I would like it to be, but I mean, at least you can see what's in the drum.
actually. I have just thought, I'm hoping it's not because my lamp's dying. I mean, it is LED, so it shouldn't be dying yet. It's only been on for probably about... maybe 17... more than 17. No, because I've had it at least half a year now. I'm thinking it's probably been on... maybe 500, 600 hours, maybe. Including the videos which never made it to YouTube. There are a lot of videos actually that never made it to YouTube. Either I called them off halfway through because something happened, or I just didn't want to upload it for some reason. Oh, it keeps fixing. I might have to ditch this one if this glitch doesn't fix itself. I mean, you can still see it, so it's not failed. What I might do is, when it starts distribution draining, I'll then focus it on the centre of the drum. What if I did this? Focus it over there for a second. And do that. I don't know if I'm making it better or worse. I think that's as good as I can do.
54.9.
Spin in a minute, well, drain at least, and then add the suds. I've noticed it builds up a lot more suds to the end of the wash than before. There's actually some suds in there for once. Use the background noise. It's at 55, by the way. I'll show you the photo I just took for proof. Now we refocus that as much as possible. Sort it out properly when it gets to the when it gets to the first drain. Right, draining. Let's see if we can sort this out properly. Is that how it's been all this time? That must just be how it's been all this time without me noticing. Let me take the light away quickly. Bear with me.
No, I don't believe that's how it's been all this time. Let me swipe the camera. I don't know. I do wonder whether my camera might be on its way out on my iPhone. Right, that's as good as I can get it. I've got to stop trying. I won't be able to get any better than it already is, so no point continuing to attempt something that won't work. Update my iPad, might as well. Updating. We might get some unbalanced spins because the bedding looks like it's all on one side actually. So, you know what that means. Gonna be a long time here. Oh, maybe not. Might say I'd probably spin this one. I'm trying to get it to focus properly, hold on. Bear with me. That's the best I can do. That's annoyingly balanced. Hang on, bear with me. I can't do anything else. So there's a glitch of some sort. There's a lighting glitch, so I've done what I can. I wonder if I focus on that, maybe it will come brighter. A little brighter.
I don't know what I've done to it, I don't know why it's not focusing. just isn't. I'm hoping I'll have better luck next week. Especially since I'll be filming LG as well next week. Training. It does like to do rather harmonious distributions, doesn't it?
Do we think it's going to spin? Wouldn't surprise me if it tried to go for that. Obviously now I said that it's not going to. That's even worse. That's the third time it's done a banging distribution. Well, it's not banging, but because it's got padding on the sides of the machine. Yes, I've worked out why it has that padding, believe it or not. You get that. Sometimes it spins first attempt and then jumps. You never know what it's going to do. I said something in the group, then I had to disappear. Now I wonder what my source of that is.
should. That was my video released a while ago. Single item test for LG. Doesn't sound very good. I reckon if it jumps once more, then the shocks are going to die. And if the shocks die, we'll have even more jumps. I wouldn't be surprised though. This machine's jumped so many times and it's hit the glass once, which I have no idea what happened. Okay, if it spins that, it's going to kill itself. One time this is just going to go straight forward and it's going to seriously hurt the machine. I think it's going to spin this one. Actually, better not spin this. I'm going to stand next to this. hold it. It doesn't even have to be spinning for it to shake the machine. I mean, it's not too dumb. Like, it does recognise that some of these spins will kill it, so it's stopping earlier than it would usually. And saying like, no, I'm not even thinking about this one. So, but sometimes it really thinks about it. No way. I could literally feel that on here through the padding. That looks better. No way. You absolutely stupid machine. You, oh my actual God. Oh my God. If I hadn't been holding that, it would have jumped like a foot into the air. That's better. Why couldn't it have done that the first time?
imagine what would have happened to the machine if I let it spin that up. Imagine if I had been out of the room then when he was doing those distributions. I wouldn't have known anything. Could have self-destructed. I wonder if this machine's going to hit a vital component inside on one of those spins. Or something's going to fall off and the machine will be unusable.
And it really won't surprise me when it happens. hopefully the final spin isn't going to be too deadly. Imagine just throwing bedding towels. Imagine being the average person, getting one of these machines, throwing bedding towels into it, not thinking any different, turning it onto cross down to 60, you come back in 2 hours later and you find the entire laundry room smashed to pieces. That's the kind of thing that this machine would do. I'm surprised it hasn't already in it. What, nearly 8 years? Well, it's definitely jumped and hit the glass once, because there's a mark here, which I'm not actually sure if you can see on the camera. No, you can't see that, because it's just an... I'll get a picture of it, and I'll put it on Instagram, just to show people that the beko has in fact hit the glass. Even though that's not hard for people to believe, it's a beko. I think it'd be harder for them to believe if it didn't hit the glass. No, it's alright. I spoke far too soon. Seriously, beko. This cycle's 2 hours long. Listen, I don't want it like that. Come on. Give me at least a tiny bit of balance. I don't want it perfect balance. That's boring. I want it slightly unbalanced, but I don't want it machine killing unbalanced. So it's either machine killing unbalanced or it's perfect balanced. There's no in between. If it spanned that wouldn't be as deadly as it as the other one that it's tried to spin. Still though, machines should not be spinning stuff like this. So machines definitely shouldn't be spinning what it tried to spin before. But there really is no in between with this machine. It's either machine killing or it's perfect balance. Actually, I lied. Didn't even have to finish what I was going to say. This is going to be a nightmare. I'll hold the top of it for this one.
If it's banging the size of distribution, there's no way that's going to spin. Even if it does, I'm not letting it.
Not if it's banging the size of distribution, that's ridiculous. No machine should swim that, ever. Not in a million years. God, can you...
Okay, that's not deadly unbalanced. It's not perfect balance either.
Okay. So you'll spin something that will kill you, but you won't spin that.
Logic won't.
See, now I bet it's going to spin this, because this is worse than the last imbalance.
This distribution is worse than the last thing it rebalanced.
If it spins this, I'm really going to question Becker's logic.
I'm concerned it's going to limit.
And it's not even limiting.
Was it going to go to 1200 or what? Slowing down too early again, so I didn't do the full spin. If anything's going to kill the suspension, it's going to be that. I can't believe you spun that to 1200. I was expecting to at least limit. Dumb machine. Wow, seriously. This is the exact reason why you can't wash at like night time in this machine. Stop correcting my words. I'm going to have to turn off autocorrect on this iPad. It's really driving me nuts. Okay, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to separate the towels out from the bedding. I'm going to do that off camera though completely because I'm then going to record a 4K60 video on my iPad and upload that to YouTube. So thank you very much for watching, guys. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, then please leave a like and I'll see you in the next video. Bye bye.